Hello guys, welcome to SWK Tutorials. Today I will be teaching you guys a professional trick that is used by professionals in almost all 3D renders. Some professionals call it OCC Pass, some call it Ambient Occlusion Pass. With this trick, you can turn your ordinary amateur renders into awesome professional renders. You can see it here. You can turn this image into this. So, without any further ado, let's get started. Ambient occlusion is usually black and white rendering that shows how objects occlude each other. If you don't understand what I mean, let me tell you in simple words. Ambient occlusion adds realism to your renders by producing soft shadows in areas of intersection, contact of your model. Ambient occlusion can be done in two ways. Number one, by clicking the checkbox in your render settings. Number two, by adding VRay extra texture map in your render elements and then compositing it in a compositing software like Photoshop or After Effects. Render and save result. I have saved this image as image 1. First, I will discuss method 1. Go to render setup. Make sure you are in your GI tab. Change default to advanced and check ambient occlusion and render. Now compare it with our previous image. Wow, we can instantly see the difference, especially at this part. Before ambient occlusion, after ambient occlusion. The new render is much more detailed. We can make it more detailed by understanding the ambient occlusion parameters. So let's discuss them. Save the result. Ambient occlusion enables or disables the ambient occlusion. A value of 0 produces no ambient occlusion, while higher values make the ambient occlusion more prominent. I will recommend not to increase it more than 1. Render and compare. Ambient occlusion off, ambient occlusion on. Off, on. Next, radius. Radius determines the amount of area where the ambient occlusion effect is produced. Usually the black color. Increase the radius to 3 feet. Render and compare the results. Save the result and compare it with our previous result. Ambient occlusion radius 3 and radius less than 3. You can instantly see the difference that the radius has increased the area of this black part. Subdivision. It controls the quality of ambient occlusion. Lower values render faster but might introduce noise. Now back to our previous scene. Increase the radius from 10 inch to 3 feet. It can be different in your renders and render it. The result looks good. But this result has one drawback. It has less options. Plus, if you want to change the result, you have to render again. So I will only recommend method 1 if you don't know any compositing softwares. Turn off ambient occlusion. Now I will discuss method 2. Go to render elements. Click on add. Click on VRay extra textures. Scroll down. Click on textures and type VRay Dirt here. Double click. Open your material editor. And drag this texture on an empty slot. You can name it anything. I will name it Ambient Occlusion. Now render and save the result. Now we have two separate renders. First is our normal RGB pass. Second is our Ambient Occlusion OCC pass. Save them and open them in Photoshop. That's my original render and that's my Ambient Occlusion render. Change it to multiply and you can see the difference. Now you can control your opacity. This is the reason I like Ambient Occlusion method number 2. Back to 3ds Max again. Now I will teach you the 4 most important parameters, then we will apply this knowledge to our interior scenes. Render and save the result. Radius. Radius helps how far the occluded color will go, which is black in this case. The more the radius, the more the black occluded color will go and vice versa. You can see it. Next, distribution. Distribution will force the rays to gather closer. The effect is that the dirt area is being narrowed closer to the contact edges. In simple words, it makes the intersection part more dark. Increase the distribution from 1 to 5 and render. Now compare the results. You can see when my distribution was 1, and when my distribution was 5, actually it gathers the rays from this part more towards the intersection part. That's why it's dark. You can see it here too, like this. Next, falloff. Falloff controls the speed of transition between occluded and unoccluded areas. Change the distribution to 1 and increase the falloff to 5. Render. Save it and compare with our earlier result. You can see when my falloff was 0 and when my falloff was 5. You can see the speed of transition between the occluded and unoccluded color. If you are confused between distribution and falloff, then just compare them. In this side my distribution was 5 and at this side my falloff is 5. You can see when my distribution was 5 that the rays have gathered more towards the intersection part. That's why it's more dark black. Whereas in falloff, you can see the speed of transition. The black color quickly disappears. Again, compare it at this side. You can see falloff 5. You can see the distribution 5. Just remember it like this. Distribution makes the intersection parts more dark, while falloff quickly goes towards the white part. Next, double-sided. When enabled, backside of faces will always be calculated in Ambient Occlusion. By black side, I mean the opposite side of face normal. I will recommend to enable it. Now, I hope these 4 parameters are clear to you. Now, you can improve your interior results by applying this knowledge. Change the radius to 1 fit. Falloff to 1. and render. This is my new result. Now go to Photoshop. Again, I will go here. Now I have a lot of control. I can, if I want this image to be dark, I don't need to render it again. I can simply go here and use my levels. And make sure when you are using levels like this, always press Alt and click here when you see this icon like this. What actually happened? I have linked this level with this image. It will not affect this background. It will only affect your OCC, not your render. I can simply increase my dark areas like this. I think so that's too much. I'm just happy with little bit here like this, so you can see. Again, I will do like the previous time. I will go to my opacity. Sorry, I will go to here and I will change it into multiply. Then I can use my, make sure your OCC pass is selected, not your levels. And simply I can play like this as much as I want. This is how I used to play with levels. Plus, sometimes I use my hue and saturation. If I want to increase slight bit of sharpness here, you can see slight change. So guys, this is how I change my flat amateur render into a professional 3D render. Remember one more thing, displacement maps show ambient occlusion, but bump map does not show ambient occlusion. If you like this tutorial, give it a like. If you love it, subscribe to my channel and share my videos. Bye guys.